One potato, two potato, three pot- well, they're not really potatoes, are they, Rex? No. Just irradiated, horrible, mutant potato root things, aren't they? I mean, it's one Xander root, two Xander root, three Xander root, really, but I mean, that doesn't quite have the same ring to it now, does it? So, forever they shall remain one potato, two potato. Probably can't even barbecue them either, can you? It's disgraceful, it really is. But never mind. Look! Look at this! Look at this! The fence is finished, and it looks fantastic. It looks awesome. It's brilliant. America, we built a wall, and well, I mean, I paid for it actually, but that's not really the point. Bad motherfucker built it. That's wait, no, that's not the point of a wall at all. The point is, it keeps out nasty critters and things from this lovely garden we've got. I should just start again, shouldn't I? Really? That's never mind. We've come this far. Well, it's a lovely day. It's a lovely day. It's a wonderful day. I wish I could just sit here and listen to the radio, frankly, but no. The copyright gods won't allow that, will they? No, not at all. What is this switch for? Oh, very good. But no, we can't do that because the copyright gods will spank me to death. And now you're all sitting there like, oh no, God, he's talking to the voices in his head again. Just because I understand the deeper mysteries of this universe that we live in does not make me completely insane, all right, you lot. Okay? I'm not mad. Now then. Where did I put my musical pistol? Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas. It's been a while, hasn't it? It's been a bit of a while. We took a sort of unofficial break. I came back to Good Springs, and we built a fence and just chilled out for a while, honestly. Last you saw us, we were in the arse end of the New Vegas ruins somewhere doing something that I don't exactly remember what. So I just, we came back, got in the truck, came back here. And sort of reset everything back to Good Springs, because I think that's easier, both for you viewers who've forgotten what the hell we were doing, and for me, who also forgot what the hell I was doing.
Yes, Rex.
I think one of the things we might have been doing, though, was heading up to Jacobstown to get your brain fixed. But I guess I'll just have to wait, so never mind. In terms of what we've been up to, that's a bit of a refresher. We're doing the same old stuff we always do. Same thing we do every night, Pinky. You know, just sort of wandering around, killing people, chopping off their fingers and getting paid to do it, and slogging onwards and trying to someday get this casino up and running that I've invested so much time and effort into. But that's, I don't know, it looks like that might be happening soon, because we need to get our asses down to Prim, because well, oh yeah, the other thing is we discovered that the Crimson Caravan and the Silver Rush were responsible for blowing up all of Cass's caravans, and he managed to, just by a whisker, talk her out of the murdering spree. We don't know how long that's going to last for, though, so we need to go see Paul about this fence one last time, apparently. And we also need to return Chuck's finger, which is getting a little bit smelly and horrible at this point. Frankly, I put it in a little Ziploc bag thingy and just it's staying there, and hopefully it won't have rotted away completely. I still don't know what Steve's using them for, but never mind. We better not ask, I suppose. Maybe he's just using them for fingerprints. I hope he's just using them for fingerprints. The other thing is, we need to let Steve know that we finally finished helping Michelangelo, the prick. If I never see that guy again, it will be too soon. Anyway, so yeah, that's what we got to do. Basically, we're off to Prim to get this casino finished and sorted out, and return to Randall with the smelly finger from Chuck Beaudry, who was the NCR Ranger who joined the Legion, I think, if I recall correctly. He had a nice suit, if I recall correctly. No, just one of his mates had a nice suit, and he was wearing this sort of Ranger outfit-y thing. We've done a lot of sorting. I put a load of weapons away in there and, you know, stuff like that. And I repaired a bunch of things. The old ballistic fist now is in full working condition. Unfortunately, I think it probably does lose condition pretty quickly on account of it being a punching weapon. And also, it cost me a lot of money to repair it. I'm not kidding, 11,000 caps. I parted with 11,000 caps to fix this thing. That is how important it is to me. On a deep, philosophical, emotional, spiritual level, that is how important the ballistic fist is to me. I parted with 11 fucking thousand caps for it. So, that's fixed, along with this wonderful piece of workmanship as well. That's fixed. I restocked all the ammo as well, that sort of thing. We're taking this with us. I junked Maria. Well, I didn't junk Maria, but it's just in a locker in there somewhere because it's basically rubbish at this point. And replaced it with this, which is just a nice little automatic rifle thingy, which also has a nice little scope on it, so that's fun. Does a little bit extra damage, and I've got loads of ammo, buckets of ammo for this thing. I've got, as you can see in the bottom right, but also there's like half of that plus more still in the locker in there, so I have buckets and buckets of 5.56 ammo. It's just, you know, it's more common than money at this point, this stuff. So I got that. We've obviously got the lovely Lee Enfield number 4. I did consider switching it out for the L96, but it doesn't do as much damage as the Enfield. I mean, I could try and get it repaired and then see, but I feel like it probably still won't do quite as much damage, honestly. I mean, it depends. How much is it going to cost me to repair? Like, that's the question. I could repair it and give it to one of you lot, I suppose, but then you'll be using my precious 308 rounds. And that's just not on, frankly. This tiny gate is a problem, isn't it? Excuse me, Dean.
Don't forget if you need some repair.
Yeah, I know. Remington 870 doesn't need repairing. 1,500 caps just to repair that tiny little bit there as well. I mean, good grief. I've got the Ranger helmet still as well, just in case I need a bit of night vision or thermal vision. The armor itself has been stashed away in a locker because it's faction armor, which means none of my companions can wear it, and if I wear it, people start thinking I'm actually part of the NCR, and that's just a recipe for disaster in the making. So, let's see. 3,500 caps, which will increase it to 67 damage, which I am reasonably sure is still not as much as this wonderful piece of kit. No, it isn't. Not even close. So yeah, I think unless I've got an option turned on whereby you guys don't need ammunition, I'm probably not gonna. I mean, I could just hand it to you, Cass, and you can make what you will of it.
Let's distribute the weight.
You've already got some 308 rounds because you've got the battle rifle, right? So, oh wait, you've already got one. Oh yeah, that's right. I picked up two, didn't I? That's true. Okay. Never mind then. Russell, do you want one?
Sure thing.
But I'll take that as a yes.
There you go. Enjoy.
You will continue to use your knife though, won't you? Of course you will. Use that knife for everything! He kills people with it, and then he later chops up his food with it. It's disgusting. It's absolutely vile. But never mind. So, that's us sorted out. We got this. We've got the AER-14 thing with the post-it note stuck on the back of it that does ludicrous amounts of damage, which is always good. The sight on it seems to be working for now. It's a little bit sort of it sort of pops in and out though, doesn't it? It doesn't quite always work as intended, unfortunately. But for now, it's working, which is nice. We've obviously got the Remington, which I've kitted out with Magnum slugs and Dragon's Breath and Pulse slugs and Flechette rounds as well for anything really nasty that comes our way. Obviously as well I've got the Ballistic Fist, so lovely jubbly. I suppose I'd better switch to this for now, just since I've pretty much just brought the H&K with me for blasting critters with. Honestly, that's really what it's here for. I mean, it doesn't have a crosshair when we're in... Well, none of them do, actually. Having said that. Well, it's been a while since I've played this, can you tell? It's wobbling around a bit, isn't it? Strength requirement is 3. I don't have any damaged limbs, do I? No, we're good. I don't even have any radiation right now. Oh, no, I didn't want to do that. How did I manage that? Weird. Anyway. Here. Yeah, I think I'll stick with that for a while. Anyway, so... yeah. I suppose we get in the truck and drive down the Prim, or we could just walk down there. Why don't we walk down there, get a bit of exercise? We've been sat around in the old, house there for ages. There's Bad Motherfucker just doing his thing by the Good Springs General Store. Having fun. You know what? I'm going to pop in here because I want to see if I can find some weapon repair kits, because they are literally more valuable than money, it turns out. If there is a store, I'm going into it from now on.
You looking to buy some supplies?
Yes. Because if you've got weapon repair kits, I want them. And you've got good ammo. I suppose he's got those. I think I brought some hollow point ammo as well for the HNK. Stimpak. Oh, I've got too many Stimpaks already. Although, I suppose there's really no such thing as too many Stimpaks at the end of the day. 100 empty water bottles! Good God. Flame of fuel. We do need that to fuel the truck with, actually, but I think we've got more than enough for now. I'm not seeing any... nothing's jumping out at me right now, other than maybe that plasma pistol. Even that's a bit meh. Ray-Ban Aviator's blue tint. Oh God, no. Respirator gas mask. Rad resistance plus 20. Hello. It's 9 caps. I'll take it, just for the novelty value. It beats the surgical mask I've got at the moment, to be honest, so... Tony's Mr. Gutsy notes. We'll leave those there. That might be useful later for something. Sentry maintenance log again, yes. Robot spit. Yeah, a lot of useful looking things here that I don't think I'm going to do anything with. Yeah, Mr. Gutsy plasma cannon. Okay, so anyway.
Give me a shout if you need anything else.
Why is the camera so...
Take it easy now.
Wonky. Okay. Let's see. Oh my God. That is truly hilarious. You know what? My award for weirdest Christmas present I got last year, by the way, was a gas mask. My father, who always buys me weird presents every year for Christmas, I think mostly because he knows I've already bought everything I actually want for myself, so he just buys me weird shit. And this year's weird present of the year was a gas mask. It was a Russian gas mask, complete with the satchel thing it comes with and the spare filters and everything. So, I mean, if Metro 2033 happens for reals, I am totally fully equipped. Doesn't look quite as badass and steampunk as this thing, though, does, I have to admit. Not even steampunk, more like Mad Max. But yeah, I bet if I had that visor effect turned on, this would look pretty cool, actually. Maybe I should turn that on. In the options. I mean, I turned it off because it was, whenever I wore sunglasses, it kind of gave me this annoying overlay, but I don't wear sunglasses anymore, so. Mod configure. I'm amazed, by the way, that this entire installation is holding together. I thought after umpteen driver updates and the thing just having sat there rotting away on the hard drive for long enough that it would be totally broken next time I ran this thing up, but nope. All I did was run Mod Organizer, load the 4GB launcher, and bang, here we are. Everything's completely fine. Sorry, I'm taking breaks every now and again to finish this cup of tea. It is the last cup of tea. Well, the second, penultimate cup of tea, because there's only one tea bag left in the cupboard. And then I'll have to go out and buy more after this. So I'm savouring it. I mean, it's either that or I get the box of Earl Grey out and start faffing around with tea strainers and stuff, but... ain't nobody got time for that shit, as the saying goes. What am I looking for here? Project Nevada Core? Features? Visor overlays. Here we go. I might have to take it off first. Well, no overlay for us, apparently. That's interesting. What about the ranger helmet? Oh, we get one for that, alright, yeah. Actually, less intrusive than I thought it would be. Surprisingly enough. How do we get this thing to... Nope! That's the VATS button! Oh dear. No, that's the auto-run button. Oh, there we go, hello. This thing is going to be useful. I don't know if I look ridiculous with it on, mind you, but... Actually, I kind of look like a... Again, slightly Mad Max. The combination of NCR Ranger helmet and flashy suit is a weird one. It really is. Strange, but anyway. Put on the duffel bag as well. Oh yeah, we are equipped for the apocalypse, folks. Right, anyway. Oh, I forgot I got the flashlight belt as well. Oh yeah. Look at all that tactical rubbish. Okay, anyway. I will be honest, I am actually a little bit disappointed that the gas mask doesn't have an overlay, but never mind. Anyway, if we run into any more Chola Mountain-esque areas, I've got this to play with. Amazingly enough, the Ranger helmet doesn't actually give you any like radiation bonuses, in spite of the fact that it's got like a gas mask and shit, so whatever. I suppose it's just meant to filter out tear gas, because it's a riot police helmet, really, isn't it? That's what all the NCR Ranger armor is. It's riot police gear from Los Angeles. Anyway, yeah, that's alright, that's cool. Let's get rid of it for now, though, thank you very much. How much does it weigh? It weighs 3, but plus 20 rad resistance. Just for wearing a piece of clothing that doesn't even make me take off my hat, I might add. Not bad, not bad. I can live with that. Right, anyway. So, let's continue. There's a gun shop down here as well, isn't there? So I think we'll pop in there. And if they don't have any weapon repair kits, then I don't know who's going to have any. But, oh dear, that's the last of the tea gone. Oh, it's been a while since we were around here, so keep an eye out for little critters. By which I really mean just coyotes, I suppose. Nothing more dangerous than that lurking around. Except for the gecko men, who seem to be continually evolving. That is to say. Right, okay. I suppose maybe in Freeside we'll be able to find a shop somewhere that's got some... weapon repair kits and stuff. Welcome to Frankie's Guns and Ammo. And you're still a mute, Frankie, aren't you? Jobs for me to do. Go on. Well, there are a few things that spring to mind. I tell you what, I have a key that leads to a place called the Underground. I used to live there for a while anyways. Used to be a great place. Now it's a damned hellhole, but chances are it's still full of loot. Personally, I never feel the need to go back in there. There's critters in them there, and they're meaner than anything I've seen out here. You can deal with a few local problems for me, then the key's yours. You won't find another entrance south of Bonnie Springs. What do I have to do? Well, like I said, the Underground's a very dangerous place. Pause for a dramatic effect, I guess. If you want the key, then you're gonna have to prove to me that you're tough enough to handle yourself down there. Go on. Okay, I happen to know... I just went Somerset for some reason. I don't know what happened there. The location of several huge mutants have been... Start off with a few geckos. Should be simple enough. Kill them and report back to me once the job is done. Okay, I'm game. Excellent. Here, I'll upload the locations to you, but boy. Yeah, okay. Whatever. What have you got in stock? Lots of stuff. Is the answer. 50 NG rounds. You know what? I need those. I really do. But they're not going anywhere for now, are they? He's not going to... do anything with them, I suppose. But I need those for my anti-material rifle. Anyway. He does always have really aha! There we go. He does always have pretty cool weapon mods, doesn't he, actually? And I might need to get some primer at some point now that I think about it. Should we just pick up some now? To be on the safe side, let's see. We've got a large pistol. A large rifle, shot shell, small pistol. And probably some powder while we're at it too. Pistol and rifle powder, there we go. 108 caps. They are all yours, sir. Hope to see you again soon. Alright. So he wants us to kill a bunch of random monsters, and that works for me, honestly. That's easier than going after people, which is what I normally do, so... Kill Firetooth, kill Labal, hunt down and kill the three giant geckos. I don't know what Firetooth or Labal are, probably... Firetooth sounds like a big-ass gecko that breathes fire, which is just gonna be real fun, and he's down this way, apparently. One of them is, anyway. In fact, one of them's right over there. Alright, you know what? Detour time! I'm glad we decided to walk down here. Switch to this for now, just so I can scope ahead. Pun not intended. Hello there, moving creature. There's a hollowed out rock up there. And a coyote.
Keeping quiet.
thanks for spotting that for me, Rex. Right, you little... I could try and hit him, but I bet there's a collision mesh in the way. Ghoulish beast. Yeah, you definitely deserve to die. Is that a vulture? It was a vulture. Now it's bits of vulture. Ghoulish beast. Ooh. 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 No, no, thank you. No. I've almost forgot I had that monster mod installed, actually. And now I do remember it's installed. I hope it's okay. Are you... Oh, yes, right. Okay, thank you for growling at me, Rex, because I forgot the hollowed out rock. You're quite right. I hope it doesn't cause any problems. I mean... it shouldn't do, but I don't know. A hammer and some flame of fuel. Whatever, I'll chuck it in the van next chance I get, I suppose. Yeah, monster mods for other Bethesda games cause problems in my experience, particularly Oblivion. I'm pretty sure that's what killed my Oblivion installation last time. Monster mods. Hopefully we'll be okay, though. I mean, you know, I'm not too worried, because I've got New Vegas Anti-Crash, which is still probably my favorite mod for New Vegas, if I'm honest. It just recodes, essentially, the way the game deals with errors, and you get a little message at the top left to tell you when the game would have crashed if you didn't have it installed. But, yeah, it doesn't actually crash half the time when you run into issues. Culling the local coyote population. Don't feel too sorry for them, they always come back. And then there's this lot that seem to have moved in recently. Okay, what can I hear? What the fuck are you? Rad horror. Okay.
Hmm.
What hole did you crawl out? You know what? I don't even want to know what hole you crawled out of. Probably somewhere like Chola Mountain, except worse. I think whatever we're after is down there in the Devil's Gullet. You can get... Wait, you know what? You might not have crawled out of this hole specifically, but you can get down there right now.
You got any spare tobacco? Never know.
Oh my god! Alright, I'm going vats on your ass. Oh boy. That was so disco, I love it. That thing just ate up the bullets I shot at it. Ash bits. Tunnel to Devil's Gullet Cave. Is it in here? I think it might be. Alright, guys. This cave wasn't here last I checked. This is recent. This entrance has just opened up. Unless my memory really is as bad as I think it is. Alright, I see some geckos have dug their way in here. That's what's going on.
Is that how you wanna play, huh?
Russell at it with the knife again. I cannot see a damn thing down here. Where the hell did you get to? Oh, I'll take the gecko meat, because actually... Golden gecko height? Nah. Value to weight ratio, folks, that's what it's all about, and that doesn't meet it, so... Golden gecko egg on the other hand, yeah, just about worth it. Yeah, I love that. And the gecko meat, obviously we can turn into gecko steaks, which are delicious. So... Ever had a tuna steak? They're kind of like that. They're a little bit like that. You know, if I was a good enough cook, maybe I could turn them into gecko burgers. Now that would be good. That would be a true delicacy. Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. You know what? I either put on the night vision helmet or get the flashlight out. If I can remember what the bloody button for it is, there we go. Take that pocket change of yours, mate. Sorry. Oh, I'm not even going anywhere near that. A single shotgun. Might be able to repair something with that and some 20 gauge rounds. And an NCR trooper. Bad luck, old chap. Yeah, I thought so. Oh, I got that glitch again. We must go deeper, apparently. Okay, leads to some sort of bunker. Don't like the sound of that. Really don't like the sound of that at all. Okay, they're gonna come through there if they're gonna come through anything. Or not. Alright, big fat gecko you were. What have we got? Long fuse, dynamite, an egg timer. I could probably make some sort of bomb with that. What have we got here exactly? Something on the other side of this wall wants us dead. Whoa, artillery shells! What the hell have we stumbled into?
Yeah.
Let me just pick this open while we figure out how to deal with the thing on the other side of the solid steel bulkhead.
Forget it.
Yeah, just dynamite. We've moved on from dynamite. Dynamite is the pass. Plasma grenade to the few. Ah, broken window to Devil's Gullet Cave. Okay. Wasn't a load door either, it was just sort of a little teleporty jobby. This has got to be like World of Pain or something, this has. The default dungeons, for want of a better term, are never this creative.
Time for some get.
Oh, ammo, come on. So you guys have got it covered anyway. Toasters, roller skates. Somebody shoot that radio! Where is it? Oh, there it is. There we go. No copyright infringement here. All right. There seems to be virtually nothing of value here at all. Even the garbage can is empty. Oh, hello. I'll take those. And those, I suppose. Alright. Oh, another big fat gecko. Lovely. I guess this was a vault? Presumably? I mean, I'm not really sure. What kind of vault has artillery shells? Pre-war book. Was there anything in that fridge? Nope. Anything hidden in the fire hose box? Nope. Careful, guys! For God's sake. This place is already a mess. Nothing interesting over here, just a huge pile of rebar and stone and keyboards, apparently. Well, it might have been something interesting down here, but I guess we'll never find out, because it looks like we can't get to anything. Oh, hello. What's this, though? Thank you very much. I'll take the cases as well, thank you. Filing cabinet. Ball caps, hooray! Vault 40 terminal. It was a vault then, okay. Sick with minor starvation. Oh dear, better eat something. Wonder glue. Yeah, I've got enough of that. Yummy food. What have I got? Grilled mantis. Thank you very much. Alright. And now we have a Vault 40 terminal. Let's see if I can get into this thing. Right. Okay. Four attempts left. Wild. 2 of 4, correct. Kill? 1 of 4. Oh, right, okay. Find? 1 of 4. Oh, dear. Told. Oh, come on. I can't explode those by shooting them, can I? Never mind. Terminal locked. Well, God, that's annoying. I bet there was some cool fluff in there, but oh well. I guess we'll never know. Hey, you gotta take the losses with the wins, haven't you, really? Just gotta accept it. Can't Kim my way out of this one. Alright. So my question is, do we actually do what we came here to do in the first place? No. No, we didn't. It was outside the entire time. Alright, fine. Interesting little detour, though. We did profit from it somewhat, so you know, that's fine by me. Honestly, glad we cleared this place out, frankly. Just for the benefit of the people of Good Springs, I suppose. Not all of them have a lovely fence like me. Energy cells. 20 gauge rounds that I never use, but I'm picking them up anyway. Because I'm a compulsive ammo looter, apparently. Plus, I'm pretty sure. Oh god, I'm pretty sure I can somehow turn those into 12 gauge. I'm not entirely certain, but I'm pretty sure I can somehow. What has happened to my frame rate? I'm suddenly playing locked at 30 frames per second for some reason. I don't really know why. That's a little odd. Maybe I need to do a good old-fashioned purge cell buffer. Yeah, I figured. There we go. Never mind. All right, so. Question is, Uwe, look, thingy, it's this way. Did we already kill it? No, hang on a minute. Hang, just 1 second. I think we might have killed one of them already. Yeah, we killed Labal and Smokey. I don't remember doing that, but we killed them. Now it's just Firetooth. Who's down this way? Alright, fine. Okay, so we did do it. Goody gumdrops. Is it getting dark, or is it just... Is there a sandstorm coming in or something? Are sandstorms a thing? I can't remember. It's just going to get very hazy. Maybe it's just going to get very hazy. What's the time? It's 2:37 PM. Right. I can't remember if I have sandstorms in this game. I don't. I just don't, genuinely don't remember. Or dust storms, or whatever you want to call them. I kind of hope I do, but I'm not. Whoa. You see that? Let's pretend that's not there. Suddenly everything got very Hunger Games on me. Yeah. Hello. I've got a big bullet with your name on it, mate. That was not Firetooth, that was just a Gecko Hunter. That is weird. Yeah, well, there you go. That's what a bunch of driver updates will do. It'll break something. You just never know what it's going to be until it happens. Whatever, we'll just ignore it. A little bit difficult to ignore, I admit, but...
Contact.
What was that? A gecko hunter, but it was an actual lizard as opposed to... a lizard man. Alright, that's different. Some of them must be devolving, I suppose. Man, that is annoying. I wonder if there's a fix for that. Well, I suppose this is the wonderful thing about making a YouTube video, isn't it? I can just yell at the YouTube comments and say, yo, guys, is there a way to fix that? And maybe someone out there on the internet will be able to tell me. Alright. Firetooth, I'm coming for you. And we're being led towards Prim anyway, which is good too, so... That is just a rock. Calm down. That was Firetooth, I'll eat my hat. Can you imagine? The great and mighty Firetooth is a tiny, tiny, tiny gecko. The size of basically a football. Probably tastes good though. He's down this way somewhere. Don't ask how I know that. I am an expert tracker. I am. Is that a, yeah, I think it is. Jalapeno peppers!
Gotcha. Serving up some hurt.
You just fucked with the wrong ranger.
Were any of you Firetooth? I don't think so. Alright, you know what? We've got enough gecko hide, gecko meat for now. Is that a Xander root? Okay. Call me up. I love you. And is that a Brock flower? No, it's a white horse. No. Okay, I don't remember if they're useful for anything, honestly. I don't remember. Probably not, is the answer. It doesn't sound useful, does it, white horse nettle? I say, Firetooth, me old mate, where are you? What's that? Nothing. With that, on the other hand, is something. He's got armor. Alright, I've got a few armor piercing rounds of this, so shall make use of it. Hello, there you go. Come on. Biggin. He's also dead now. Did he have friends? I just want to check if he was wearing brass knuckles like that other one. Warrior get. Yes! Brass knuckles. I tell you, they're getting more intelligent. What would really worry me? Rock flower. There we go. I can make some healing powder now. What would really worry me is if they make the brass knuckles themselves. This place is absolutely infested, isn't it? Oh god, how do we get up there? I mean, I can hop like a mountain goat, but you guys, on the other hand, are gonna have issues. More Xander root. And more Brock flower. And ruined railway tracks? Oh, come on, really? There we go. Hello. God damn it. Alright, fine. Have it your way. Are you serious right now? Warrior geckos, not to be trifled with, it would seem. They just eat sniper bullets, apparently. I saw something move. Yeah, there is something moving over there.
You like them?
All right, he's dead. Good. And
just fucked with the wrong ranger.
Firetooth is going to be in his own little bunker, isn't he? Or something like that. Something really annoying that's going to take a while to get through. I can already tell. I was hoping he'd just be standing out here on a hillside somewhere, but I don't think that's going to happen, is it? I've got that feeling in my bones that we're going to have to go through a lot to get to Mr. Firetooth. Veronica is busy punching something somewhere, apparently. Hello. So we're on another one of those lizardy geckos. Sounds like such a stupid thing to say, doesn't it, lizardy gecko? But, you know, it's the truth. Stop accidentally clicking the left mouse button, you fool. Alright, this looks... If he's going to be anywhere, it's going to be in here, right? Yeah, I'm kind of thinking yes. Firetooth Caverns! Look, they're even named after him. This gecko, whoever he is too big for his britches, if you ask me. Although, you know what? The marker's actually pointing to somewhere here, but... I don't know. I mean, if he's not actually in the Firetooth Caverns, then I don't know what to say. So... Alright, standard operating procedure. Shotgun equipped. Avengers assemble, come on. For heaven's sake. You really just gonna make me and Rex do this all by ourselves, you idiots. I tell you, henchmen, Rex, what are they good for? Nothing is the answer to that question, and is also, as it happens, how the song goes too, but... Oh, for God's sake.